Hey, friends and family, I'm in the mood and the sun is shining and I have a little bit of free time, so I'm gonna try and show some records. And I think my jumping off point that I have in mind is that one of the videos that I watched is Brian, who's doing his Prague series. He's up on his Yes collection now, and I quite like Yes. They're not my favorite prog band. You know, it's pretty obvious that, you know, Genesis means a lot to me, but we're not going to compare. But I thought what I'd do is start by vibing with him by showing some Yes records. I didn't get them all together. I've got some singles and stuff. But before I do that, I wanted to share that I've listened to this again today. Fufa Andrea. Black Trommel 90 gave this to me, sent this to me, Vinyl Love Train earlier this week. Really good. Italian band, they remind me of a slower Fugazi in some kind of way, as well as the band having a lot of angst and emotion. There's some interesting sounds and playing going on here. The cover is fitting. Dancing Judas. Yes, I played that again today, and I've listened to the Alpha Taurus all the way under it. It's so wonderful. I'm going to grab, is that most of it okay? Let's start here with these records, trying to show you my Yes, but let's see what this record is. Okay, so we have Yellow Swans, X-Cocaine split. That goes into my Yes. Here's Yes's first album. This is on a Red Canadian Atlantic. Time and a Word, the U.S. version, yeah. Brian did a really good job of pointing out some of the little idiosyncrasies about this record. You know, the transition. Steve Howe on the front, Peter Banks on the back. The Yes album, but of course, just really excellent. Just excellent. German copy of Fragile. My original copy of this was one of those things that was hard-earned as a teen, because again, didn't have much money, but I ended up loaning it to a bunch of kids at high school. Matter of fact, actually, it got out of my hands. It went from one friend to another. He said, so-and-so really needs to hear this. All these kids at prep who, you know, it's like, don't they have any money? But they were borrowing my record. I turned a lot of kids onto Yes with Fragile. Close to the Edge, but of course, nothing much more to be said about that. Yes Songs, the three record live set. Alan White on drums. Yeah, I met Alan White about 4 years ago at a Porcupine Tree concert. The opening band was a band I think called Three, and Alan White was friends of theirs, and he was just out strolling through the audience before Three played. I'm pretty sure that's the name of the band. I saw one person stop him, so I just stopped him briefly. He was cool. You know, he was, you know, get approached by a lot of people, but, you know, it's like, get that eye contact and things are cool. Tales from Topographic Oceans. It's just one I don't listen to very much, you know, and when it came out, it was like, ew, but it's okay. I don't base what I'm saying on what critics say. I'm basing it on my experience. You know, this has moments. But this is one of the least memorable Yes albums to my ears. Relayer. Love this album. This is when I finally saw them. Saw Yes twice. Yeah. Both times with Patrick Mraz. I never got to see him with Rick Wakeman. And both times with Mraz was excellent. I saw them on this tour, Relayer. This was great live. Yesterday's, some older songs, kind of a comp, with the wonderful Roger Dean artwork. drama. The guys from the Buggles join Yes. What a strange combination that works. I love this album. I love all. This is very good. It's Yes. It is. Tormato. Again, this one, it's like whatever they were trying to achieve here, it just does not gel. Mm-mm. So this is one I don't play. Here is a fantastic Yes album. Going for the One. Oh my word, this is just everything working. Everything is working. This is just fabulous, Yes. Fabulous. Big Generator, Yes. Again, there's moments. There's good songs on here. Let's see, Shoot High, Aim Low is one that I think is very good on here. This is Yes. 90120, is that it? 90125, just like almost like the TV show. And again, there's a few good songs on here. Leave It, you know. Changes, It Can Happen. Still Yes. Here's a 12-inch single for Leave It. And there's a Hello Goodbye mix. So that's my Yes as far as Yes, Yes. I have quite a few of the solo albums. I did, again, I'm just vibing. What's next, though, in my Ys? Masakazu Yoshizawa. Kyori, Inner Visions. This is it Shakuhachi? Yes, he's playing Shakuhachi. And Osamu Kitajima is also on here, who was originally, I believe, in the Far East Family Band. There was some talk about that online recently in the Facebook Final Community. That's what's next in my Ys. What's next? Oh, Yip Yip. Two Kings of the Same Kingdom. Kind of a Devo-ish electronic duo. This is cool. I gotta pop this out. It's one of those albums where it's split color. Thankfully, this one is done well, so you don't hear it. That's what's not cool about some of these records that where they play with the colors like that. You actually hear, you know, the vinyl difference, which is not pleasing. And then what's next? Susumu Yokota. Oh, this is just about damaged. Blake Sleeve, but Susumu Yokota. I can't remember what I read about this guy, but this is some really wonderful sample-based. Grinning Cat is the name of this album. This is just really a very, very interesting work that he does. It's on the Leaf label. This is something I remember finding used in New York. You know, the type of thing that I'm always looking for when I was able to afford to look. Excellent. I'm not sure what to compare him to. It's just really, really, really nice. So that, and then I thought also, just since if I do this quick enough, that, you know, I can stick these back right quick, and another spot that I'll grab from is right behind me. Okay. All right, I'll put those. Yeah, okay. So you always see me sitting here, and I know my Bill Camerata has mentioned that he always notices the this spine right here, which is Gong. So let me just grab this section. It's my Gong is incomplete, but I'll start with where I grabbed them. The first thing I have here is Heiner Goebbels and Alfred Harth, two German musicians, composers, whose work is just, I think, phenomenal. excuse me. Oh man, it's like, take note of the names and have a listen online. Everything comes to mind from Faust to Henry Cow to Art Bears and free jazz even and contemporary classical. Here's another Heiner Goebbels and Christoph Anders on Goebbels, Harth, Paul Lovins is on drums on here. Anna Marie Roloff's trombone and Christoph Anders. So this is on the Joppo ECM label. Haven't played this in a while, but I do know that this is not prog. This is more in the jazz. Improvisational, probably. I'm going to have to play this. Actually, yeah, we're just going to go with this. It's only 11 minutes in. It's been a while since I've played this, so let's do this together. Nice insert. I mean, already it's just wonderful already, you know. It's just getting started and it's just fantastic. This is, what's next here? Frankfurt Peking by Goebbels and Harth. I just grabbed, you know, trying to get the gong. This is alphabetically what comes before G-O-N. G-O-E, Goebbels and Harth here. Ah, this stuff is just so good. And this is on FMP, Free Music Production. I cannot get enough of this label. Not cheap either. Goebbels and Harth live at Victoriaville. Yeah. Go, 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 Earhart. This is on Gold Standard, which is a label that whenever I have seen it cheaply, I usually pick them up. I have to listen to this. I just have a... Oh, okay, this is out of order here. Another Goebbels and Harth album. Vom Springen der Garten. Oh, yeah. Another Free Music Production album. And that's the other nice thing about going through my records is I know that I have these records, but I forget. You know what I mean? Golden Palominos. I just have this first one. Bought it when it came out. This is really good. This is just very excellent. And then now we're into my gong, starting with their first album, Magic Brother. Met them in 96. Everyone signed the bet. not everyone, but David Didier and Gilly Smith signed the album for me. I met everyone in the band, though. Camembert Electrique. This is on Actuel. An original copy, it's a gatefold. Continental Circus, it's film soundtrack. Original. Flying Teapot. This is the UK version on Virgin. Here there's a French version, and this is a reissue made in Portugal of I believe the French mix. It's slightly, just slightly different of Flying Teapot. There's a gatefold of this. I used to have, believe it or not, I gave it to a friend when I was really young. I mean, I got into Gong when I was a kid. We're just so crazy when we're kids. Angel's Egg. Yeah, this I got this when it came out. This I'll open up. This is an original on the original Virgin label. Great gatefold. And the original Virgin black and white label. Yeah. And as I'm sitting here listening to the Goebbels and Harth, this is just really vital. This is really sounding good. I hope you can catch a little bit of it in the background here. So here's my original copy of You, Gong, You, the last of the Flying Teapot trilogy. And this is ring-worn because of mucho partying. And then UK version. Just love Gong. As you'll see, I didn't grab my CDs. I'm just grabbing vinyl. I have the missing albums that I don't have on vinyl, I have on CD. Gong et Mort. This is the spine that you can see, the stripe in the background, depending on how I'm sitting. And interesting thing about this album was that this is a double live album that they allow. They was released on Tapioca Records in France while they were under contract still with Virgin. So Steve Hillage's face and I think his wife, Mirette Garaudy's faces are whited out because I do believe that Virgin did not get permission for this. And there's David Allen sitting in the blue. Really was wonderful to meet David Allen. He's a prankster. I mean, he's a very intelligent man, has a heart of gold, but he's also human, you know what I'm saying? And there are those who would probably tell you some pretty horrid stories about his business dealings. We're all human, you know, and like I say, the music business sucks. Here and Now, Gong with Here and Now, Floating Anarchy. This has come up a few times recently in the vinyl community. Gong Espresso. It's under the name Gazeuse in the UK and Europe. This is the first one with Alan Holdsworth on guitar. I love this album. So this is where they're moving into the prog fusion area. And then now here, Pierre Morland's just taken over. Pierre Morland's Gong Espresso 2. And this is still musically very good, very, very tasty. Really good. Here we have Pierre Morland's Gong. Maybe I have them out of order, but here we have this. Is this a German import? No, it's US. And the other one I have, Time is the Key. That's what I have of Gong. There's a live album that I don't have on vinyl. That's a double on Virgin. I have it on CD. And the next thing that's in my G's is Delia Gonzalez and Gavin Rushem, The Days of Mars. This is pretty cool. So I just thought I'd play, you know, talk about some music. Not going to keep going too much longer. One other thing that I played from the techno that's really cool is Zoo Brazil. Zoo Brazil Needs You. It's on the Harth House label. Harth House, when it comes to this type of stuff from Germany, to be trusted. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Okay, folks. I'm just going to sign off here for now. Yeah, whatever it is, I keep thinking I'm forgetting it. Talk to you later.